Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, and welcome on board the Maid of the Forth. Just as we leave the pier, can I ask you to please pay attention to the following short safety announcement. For your safety, do not climb on, lean over, or sit on the guardrails on the upper deck. Please do not interfere or tamper with any safety equipment on board. In the unlikely event of an emergency, you will be kept informed, told exactly what to do via this public address system. Keep calm and follow the instructions. The vessel is equipped with life jackets for everyone on board, and these are stored in the clearly marked compartments throughout the vessel. The vessel is further equipped with life rafts with capacity for everyone on board. The vessel is licensed to carry 225 passengers. And you must not throw any litter overboard. Thank you for your attention.
The same size as some of the London Underground rail tunnels. Rivet catchers who are experts in throwing and catching red-hot rivets as they balance precariously hundreds of feet up in the air. Unfortunately, over 70 people were known to have died during the construction, but the actual number may be well over 100, as only those who died on site.
It's 150 feet, which means that many of the world's largest cruise liners are too big to pass under the bridge, so I have to anchor just to release. Passengers are taken ashore from Hawes Pier in small tenders. The Royal Navy's new Queen Elizabeth-class aircraft carriers, built on the side, have collapsible radio masts and radar in keeping with elevation. Now, the secret of the island. sailors from anchor were all at this turnpike, and these huge ships.
Within the fort, Inchkeith has been used for defence purposes since the 14th century. Regular attack from English raiders during the Scottish Wars of Independence.
Because the crew is infidel and the science. supporting government operating jointly to Shell and Exxon. The gas processed at Bristol, a few miles inland from here, and the LPG gas is pumped down here to Brayfoot to be loaded into gas tankers. Soon, we'll be arriving at Inchcook.
Please have your cameras ready as we're about to pass the picture postcard view of Inchcombe Abbey on your right. The littlest are both in marine birds, and you can barely see these away from the sea. After the nesting season is finished, they head back out to the boat to see you. That's the feeling.
In recent years, the houses are but these have been traced back to the original spin used on the navigation towers and some of the aircraft that were demolished in 1812. The Ministry of Defense have now admitted liability and are working on a plan to secure the site and systematically remove all of the radioactive contamination.
Built back in 1880 by Sir Thomas Pouch. all that remains of the first attempt to build a fourth bridge. He was famous for designing and building the Tay Rail Bridge at Dundee. After completion of the Tay Bridge, he was knighted and awarded the contract and design to build the fourth bridge. However, his Tay Bridge was elegant and magnificent balanced cantilever design. In construction of a new bridge, named the Queensferry Crossing, started in 2011 and was scheduled to take 5.5 years to complete.